This video is intended to be a walkthrough of configuring Active Directory Federation Services, ADFS, with ClickSense Enterprise on Qlik Cloud Services, QCS. This video will not be completely exhaustive, but will guide you through a straightforward, common configuration. Additional documentation on configuring QCS can be found on help.qlik.com. Beginning under ADFS Management, we are going to select Add Application Group. We'll give that group a name, and then we'll select Server Application. And then we're going to copy the client identifier that was generated and append it to the full name of our QCS tenant. If you have not yet configured your QCS tenant, that is okay. However, you will want to confirm what the name will be before adding it here. For the redirect URI, we will paste in the full URL, but this time, instead of adding the client ID to the end, we will add /login/callback. This is the endpoint that the response must be sent to in QCS. We will then add that URI, and we're going to copy our entire client identifier for later use. Select Next. We then select Generate a Shared Secret, and we'll copy that secret to our clipboard and temporarily save it. Select Next, and close out all of the dialogues. We now need to edit that application group and add another component, in this case, a web API. We'll copy the client ID that we created, including the full tenant domain, and we're going to use that as the identifier. We'll add it, select Next, and then we're going to leave Permit Everyone under the access control policy. You could, of course, refine this policy as needed. Select Next again, and now we're going to assign the scopes that are required. OpenID is already selected, as we are using the OIDC protocol for authentication. And we'll also select All At Claims, Email, and Profile. We can then finish out the dialogues having completed this section. We now need to edit this API application so that we can customize the claims that are sent. We select Issuance Transform Rules and select Add Rule. This part of the documentation is going to be specific to your organization, meaning what attribute is used for the distinct user ID in your system, what attribute you want to use for the display name, whether you want to send groups, which we do encourage, or whether you are going with a hybrid-based approach, in which case you need to confirm that your user directory matches the realm and that your user ID also matches the subject. In this video, our ClickSense environment is going to be leveraging the domain Qlik-POC with same account name as the user ID. So in this case, we need to confirm that the final IDP subject is Qlik-POC/same account name. That way, users are interpreted the same across all of your ClickSense systems. If you are only planning on using QCS, you will not have to worry about the domain here and can set it in QCS statically. If you have multiple domains that are trusted with a singular instance of ADFS for authentication, you will need a way to pass multiple domains, and setting a static domain won't suffice. We can achieve this by leaving the realm value in QCS empty and sending win account name as a claim from ADFS, which includes both the domain and the user ID. This claim can then be used as the subject, which QCS will be able to parse both the domain and the user. This method allows for dynamic domains versus static if it were to be hard-coded as a string in QCS. We will follow this method in this video, as it can also be used for single domain environments. So, in this example, we need to set up two rules. One rule to add the groups and display name attributes, and another rule to send a custom pass-through claim so that we can access the win account name, which includes both the domain /username as a composite claim. Just to reiterate, this second rule is only necessary for multiple domain names. I will call out where to add the user ID for use with a static domain in the creation of the first rule. Let's begin by selecting Add Rule and confirming that Send LDAP attributes as claims is selected. Select Next and give it a name. In our case, this rule will only be mapping the groups and display name attributes. However, if you have a single or static domain, you would also be adding your attribute for user ID, such as SAM account name or UPN, in the first rule here. Let's now add our first attribute, which is groups, and we'll use the unqualified names and name it groups. Next, let's add our second attribute, which we'll use display name, and we'll give it the name display name. Lastly, you'd more than likely select your user ID attribute to send, as you can see SAM account name here. But we'll do that in the next rule, since we also need the domain name attached to it. Select finish, and then I realize I've forgotten to select Active Directory as the attribute store. So I do so and then select finish again. Now, I'm going to create my second rule to pass along the domain name and SAM account name in one attribute so that I can handle multiple domain values. Again, this secondary rule is not required for single domains. Now we select add rule again, and this time we need to select pass through or filter an incoming claim. This will allow us to select the win account name claim. Select next, and now we give the rule a name. I'm just going to name it win account name after the claim. And then we're going to look up the win account name field from the dropdown and then select it. And that's it from the ADFS side. We can now close out of all dialogues and move on to the QCS configuration. We can now navigate to the QCS tenant and select Setup and Identity Provider. Alternatively, you can navigate to the console and find the identity provider there. Select Create New, and let's leave the type set as Interactive, as we are configuring the IDP for user logins and not machine-to-machine interactions. Select ADFS from the provider dropdown. We're now going to paste in our ADFS discovery URL, which we can find under ADFS Management, Endpoints, OpenID Connect. This path needs to be appended to the FQDN of your ADFS server or proxy. Next, we enter our client ID, and then we enter our client secret. And typically, we would enter our user domain value here as the realm, but again, we are handling for multiple domains, so we'll leave that value blank. And we're going to send the subject as win account name, which is going to include the user domain / SAM account name. Name we will change to display name. And groups we will leave the same as groups. We will now select create. And this is just letting us know that we can only have one interactive IDP. And we see a success. And here we can analyze the response and confirm all of the claims values. We can see that Qlik-POC/DPI has been passed through. We can then also see that the group values have been passed through as well. After we finish validating our claims, we can switch our IDP to active, log in, and then confirm that our IDP subject is indeed correct. You've now successfully configured ADFS with QlikSense Enterprise on Qlik Cloud Services.